Hi, I'm Nate from Heidolph, and today we're going to troubleshoot our Heidolph Tuttnauer Sterilizer. Right off the bat, four simple solutions that'll solve 50% of your problems are to first, run your chamber bite cycle every 20 cycles. That's really important with maintaining your unit. You should keep up on that. Secondly, when it comes to water reservoir, make sure the water level is not too high, not too low. It should be right underneath your safety valve. Also, always make sure you use distilled water. I cannot stress that enough. It is very important to the life of your unit. Lastly, do not overload your chamber. If you put too much stuff in there at one time, it can affect your sterilization. Now we'll go on to the specifics. So if you're experiencing a low heat, a high pressure, or if your unit is taking a long time to heat up, the most likely cause is that your air jet is clogged. It's also the number one cause for failing spore tests. So to fix that, you're gonna pull off your reservoir cover, grab a pen or anything long. Inside, you're gonna see a wire circle connected to your air jet, and you're just gonna push your pen inside it and move it forward and back about 10 times while your unit is running and under pressure. If you do that, it'll clean it right out and it should solve those problems. Now on to cleaning out your water strainer. If you find that you're having issues with your water not draining back into your reservoir after you run a cycle, the issue probably lies with your chamber strainer being clogged. To fix that, we're going to unscrew this plug in the back right here, which will reveal your chamber strainer. Then you can just pull them right off, run them right underneath the sink, just rinse them out, make sure it's not clogged any longer, and then you're good to go. Plug them right back in, and then screw it back on. From there, you're ready to resume operation. And so now, we're going to go over common issues with your chamber. So if you find you're getting a low pressure, a low water, or a low temp, along with maybe your wraps coming out a little burnt, the problem probably lies with not a lot of water getting into your chamber. So to fix that, you're going to have to look at your water level sensor, which you'll find in the very back of your unit. It's probably just dirty, which happens over time. You want to make sure you grab a cloth and just wipe around it and on top of it. And once you've done that, should be good to go. The water will come in the correct amount. Also, I want to mention that some people may have trouble with their unit leaking a little bit. It's a really simple fix. The problem is you're just not tightening it enough. So what I recommend is you tighten it until you hear the click, and then you go a full couple more turns until it gets real tight. That should stop any leaking from your unit. And now to wrap up, I'm going to show you some troubleshooting fixes for your panel. If you find that your panel is frozen, the simplest fix to this problem is just to hold the stop button for 2 seconds. This should reset your panel and let you go right back on working. Another common inquiry we get is regarding the printer. Sometimes you're spitting out printer paper, but not actually printing. This is due to the nature of thermal paper, only printing on one side. The side you're going to be printing on is the top, so you want to make sure you insert your printer paper over the top like so. That should fix your problem right there. So that was all the basic troubleshooting we have for you today. Thank you very much, and please give us a call if you have any other questions.